Dawson's achievements and to invoke the spirit of creativity and artistic integrity his achievements represent. And we're delighted to see all of you this year's event. I would ask that you turn off your cell phones or put them on vibrate if you have not already done so. At this time, Dr. Gregory Gray, Dean of the Chapel, will give the invocation.
Good evening. Let us receive the invocation. Grant thy divine presence of God upon this annual William Levi Dawson Institute for all that it has come to mean in the life and work of this university. May thy blessing touch the lives of those who have traveled from near and far to participate in the events of this weekend at historic Tuskegee University. We marvel at the ways in which the arts give expression to our experience of the sacred, be it through music, dance, poetry, painting, literature, drama, sculpture. We're grateful for the ways in which this concert and the lifting of voices and other instruments in melodious song may lift our spirits to what is highest and best in the human condition. May all that occurs here this evening represent a fitting and appropriate tribute, not only to Dr. William Levi Dawson, but to all those who would celebrate divine inspiration through the arts. For the sake of the more excellent way we pray, let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
We begin our musical selections with the Tuskegee University Concert Band, conducted by Mr. John Coulinard, performing John Philip Sousa's King Cotton.
Thank you.
hear from the Tuskegee University Alumni Choir.
Thank you. told much about Jesus and about good news.
Good news.
I got a hope in the kingdom. Ain't that good news?
Done.
for soon there will be done with the troubles of the world, going home to live with God.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I'm going to live with God.
I want to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I'm going to live with God.
Thank you.
The Tuskegee University Concert Band has enjoyed a long history of excellence. In 1906, Tuskegee Institute could boast of a well-organized band of 35 pieces and an 18-piece orchestra. In 1931, the School of Music was established under the directorship of William L. Dawson, and the band became a component of the newly formed department. The list of past band directors includes Dr. William P. Foster, Dr. Lucius Wyatt, and Mr. Warren Duncan, chair of Tuskegee University's Department of Fine and Performing Arts. The band's current director, Mr. John Hugh Lennard, earned his BS degree in music education at Florida A&M University, where he was a member of the famed Florida A&M Marching 100 Band. Mr. Lennard has served as a high school band director in Homestead, Miami, and Orlando, Florida, and Tuskegee, Alabama. He has appeared in Europe and the Caribbean, and has performed with many well-known artists, including Wynton Marsalis, the Ohio Players, Nat Adderley, and the Count Basie Orchestra. His career continues to evolve with his appointment as director of bands at Tuskegee. The Tuskegee University Concert Band performing The Symphonies by Clifton Williams.
Thank you.
under the direction of Mr. Joel Jones.
Once I'm in his care. Alabama State. State Choir and Claflin University, and none other than the Tuskegee University Golden Voices, along with the Alumni Choir. So let's give them all a round of applause. At this time, we'd like to recognize each of the directors with respective institutions. So I'd like for Jacqueline K. Richardson, director for Stillman College, if you would come forward, please, to receive a gift. As Mrs. Richardson is coming, we'd also like to recognize Dr. Joel C. Jones, Alabama State University. We'd also like to recognize Dr. Isaiah McGee, director from Claflin University. Mr. John Lennard, director. And we'd also like to recognize Kim Jones, director of the Tuskegee University of Alabama. Dr. Loretta Burns, as she would come down and receive her gift. And while we don't have a gift presentation, I couldn't go any further without recognizing our own Dr. Barr, who is the music director.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful program. Want to know if Dr. Velma Black Belt happens to be in the house? If so, raise your hand. Okay. Is Mr. Freddie Washington here? Okay. All right. I'd like to make special presentations on behalf of the Alumni Choir. Mr. Bruce Heath, will you step forward, sir? Bruce wasn't here last year. He was actually one of our recipients last year, and he was on duty with AIAA, so I wanted to make sure that he got public recognition for his dedicated service to our organization. and it reads for outstanding service and dedication to Tuskegee University Alumni Concert Choir. And today is April the 9th, 2016. Thank you, my brother. Recipient is Mr. Holman Edmond. He is not able to be here, but I talked with Brother Edmond earlier this week, and he sends his regards to everyone and his regrets that he could not be here. We will mail him his award. So let's give him a round of applause. Now, we wanted to give a special honor to this particular young man. He has been most valuable in assisting our getting our coordination, our rooms and stuff, so that we can practice all these years, and he's become a friend and brother, Dr. Wayne Barr.
Thank you. with arranged for the Emmanuel Nine, of course, the tragedy in Charleston, South Carolina. So Stacy arranges for us as she's sang at a Emmanuel church this evening.
Oh, no.
are amazing, and we cannot say enough in praise of their efforts. What better way to honor Dawson than to feature excellent performances by accomplished musicians? Programs like these also serve to remind us of the importance of the arts in our lives. There's a well-known saying, if I had but two loaves of bread, I would sell one and buy hyacinths to feed my soul. The arts nourish our souls. They nurture our material lives. They help fill our spiritual needs. They are an essential part of what makes us human. And the annual Dawson Concert, a celebration of the art of music and the life and work of William Dawson, never fails to enrich and to inspire. Once again, we'll hear from the Tuskegee University Concert Band performing In Chum by Robert W. Smith.
Thank you. Thank you.
pride and the richest of choral traditions. Since its inception, the Tuskegee Choir has served as an artistic model while carving its place in American history. The school choir was developed in 1886 because Booker T. Washington had determined that the Institute was in need of a group of singers who could lead vesper services and sing for special campus occasions. A new era began for the Tuskegee Choir in 1930 under its most renowned director and educator, William L. Dawson, the dean of African American choral composers. His tenure was marked by performances for the grand opening of Radio City Music Hall, President Herbert Hoover and President-elect Franklin D. Roosevelt at Constitution Hall in Washington, D.C., and for a host of television and radio programs. The choir has since appeared at many prominent concert halls and auspicious occasions. It has performed at Carnegie Hall. It was invited to the National Christmas Tree Lighting Ceremony by President John F. Kennedy, and to the National Prayer Breakfast and the White House by President William Jefferson Clinton. On January 18, 2015, in celebration of the release of the movie Selma, the choir was invited to sing the Grammy Award-winning song, Glory, John Legend and Common, on the Edmund Pettus Bridge. The choir tours annually. The 2012 Northeastern tour included a performance at the 94 College Fund Banquet in New York. The choir also returned to Lincoln Center for this tour, marking the 40th anniversary of its 1972 appearance there as the first all-black choir to perform in that venue. The 2016 spring tour took the choir to Mobile, Alabama, and through the state of Georgia, where it presented concerts in Tallahassee, Jacksonville, Tampa, Miami, Orlando, Panama, and Pensacola. Dr. Wayne A. Barr is director of choral activities at Tuskegee University. He earned degrees in church music and choral conducting from Westminster Choir College, Southern Methodist University, and the University of Michigan. Under his direction, the Tuskegee Choir has toured the Midwestern and East Coast regions of the United States and the San Francisco Bay Area. The choir has also presented numerous concerts throughout the Southeast. As an organ recitalist, Dr. Barr has twice been a featured organist at the Color of Music Festival in Charleston, South Carolina. From 2009 to 2015, he was co-director of the Italian Opera Study Abroad Program, which offers students of historically black colleges and universities a four-week study of Italian opera with a renowned coach in Italy. As a regional conductor for the 105 Voices of History, a choir made up of student representatives of the 105 HBCUs, as defined by the White House Initiative, he has prepared students and served as organ accompanist for the 2008 in 2009 Kennedy Center performances of the 105 Choir. He also served as a national conductor in 2010 Kennedy Center performance. In February 2015, he presented concerts with the Bolivian Choir and American soloists at La Paz and Cochabamba, Bolivia, under the auspices of the U.S. Embassy in Bolivia. Dr. Barr continues Tuskegee's legacy of distinguished choral directors. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Wayne Barr and the Tuskegee University Golden Voices.
What a beautiful song.
Let me say, as the closing choirs are coming, I was remiss in acknowledging our trustees that are here this evening. So I do know Trustee Floyd Griffin is here. If he would stand up and be acknowledged. Also require any local or governmental officials in the audience tonight, if you would stand and be acknowledged as well. And last but not least, I would like to recognize the president of our First Lady, Mrs. Johnson, if you would stand and be recognized.
your left, not against the doors, but against the wall to your left. Thank you again, and good night.
Thank you.